Love them or hate them, there's no one quite like them. So let's find out why Hanabie's latest song, Otaku, goes where other bands didn't. Hi there and welcome back to Japan, and first of all, let's address the juxtaposition elephant in the room of the fact that I really enjoy this band, but every time I drop a review of them, I can't help but notice that I get quite a few dislikes on these videos, which is rather interesting considering I'd consider myself to be one of the strongest supporters and proponents of what Hanabie do. See, Hanabie are one of those bands who definitely inspire pretty strong emotions from both the people who love them and also the people who, well, hate them. And to be honest, they're a band who, in my opinion, both represent a lot of the most fun and creative things that you can do with metal music, as well as representing a lot of the creativity of Japanese songwriting. They represent a little bit of an interesting example of the sort of twee Japanese pop culture, whilst also at the same time being really great at blurring genres together, talking about daily life in Japan. So many things about them are really interesting and exciting, but it would be fair to say that in the same way that they inspire people who want something interesting to be done with their metal music, they also do somewhat seem to tick off people who, you know, are more old school metalheads and have a set idea of what they think metal should be. So much to their chagrin, here is Hanabie doing all these crazy bizarre things. And so I can understand why when you're talking about Hanabie, a lot of people are on the edge, whether they be on the defense or on the attack over this band. I mean, I'm not saying that you have to like them, but surely you have to respect the creativity that goes into Hanabie's music. So where do I stand in this? Well, as you probably gathered, my love for Hanabie stems from adoring the way they write and structure their songs. My field of expertise, I guess? The fact that their music is alive with ideas and sounds that their contemporaries wouldn't dare or perhaps even be able to touch. Not since Babe Metal has a group both so convincingly been metal and yet so incredibly been tongue-in-cheek and fun about it. And let's face it, Babe Metal don't even strike that balance particularly well themselves anymore. But it's also true to say that I am perhaps more approaching Hanabie from the side that prefers the experimentation and writing to the growling and roaring vocals that many hear as Hanabie's metal battle cry. Where many come to scream along with Yukina, I guess I'm always more excited to hear what mad fusion of sounds the rest of the band is offering. I know, Yukina earns a lot of adoration and I don't question that she deserves it, but I'm always a little bit more focused on what Matsuri is doing. It's no negative to Yukina's metal vocals, I guess that I just never was so much into that kind of thing. So, truth be told, I and most Hanabie fans like the same thing, but perhaps for different reasons. Anyway, I therefore always approach reviewing Hanabie with a slight sense of awareness that some may write off the review of a less metalhead fan such as I, in the same way that less imaginative metalheads may themselves write off Hanabie's reinvention of the genre altogether. So where does that leave me with this song, Otaku? What makes Otaku work so well, given that we've already established why Hanabie themselves are such a fun concept? Well, first of all, Otaku sets out a pretty solid beat from the start, actually kicking off with a bit of a metal over EDM vibe. Heavy beat, roaring guitar, slick production. What it does from here is a glorious mix of playful changes, but whilst keeping that initially established head-banging tempo signposted throughout. Yukina's vocals go between cutely spoken and intensely roared while Matsuri sings in that earworm chorus. The drums gleefully bounce between rhythms and feels going through half time and double time while the guitars skip from riffing frantically to blasting chords. But it holds together because that underlying tempo is always there beneath the surface, chugging along. The song feels like a relentless and unstoppable force because as much as it throws many different ideas at you musically, it never gets so full of itself as to interrupt that relentless pace. The song has its louder and its lighter moments, even its total beat breaks, but the speed you start bouncing your head at the beginning is the same speed you'll be bouncing your head at the end and all the way throughout. You'll never feel the need to stop along the way and you'll never even want to, and once that canvas is established, the band fill in the gaps in the rhythm with enough ideas to medicate an ADHD sufferer. But the song's twists and turns are not just slapped carelessly on top of a simple set beat. The whole thing requires that the band creates an arrangement with a lot of unity. When the drums drop out, Yukina's vocal gets more frantic and the guitars become more intensely riffing to pump you up. When Matsuri belts out the chorus vocal, the guitars settle into a low charge and the beat solidifies to give a bed of sound for the vocals to glide atop. When Yukina roars, the guitars and drums move into more of a punchy set of stabs to accent the rhythm and back up that fury. This is more than just throwing ideas at a wall, it's a set of well-constructed changes that never loiter so long as to become boring, but equally don't scupper the charging energy of the song by tripping over themselves, trying to be too clever, and not working together. So in conclusion, Otaku certainly is a solidifying of Hanabie's sound, their personality, their attitude towards experimentation, and their love for crowd-pleasing songs. But most of all, I'd love this to be a rallying cry of a band who should just unify music fans. Metal fans should see them as a fresh take on the genre, and non-metal fans should be welcomed in by the accessibility and playfulness of their sound. The undeniable conclusion is that we should all end up with a quality product, and if you could excuse the cliche, there's more about Hanabie that should bring us together than separate us. For a band to appeal to so many different people for different reasons, that's a great unifier. I mean, it must be said that when I was there enjoying the YouTube premiere of this song, there were some trolls in chat. And, you know, when it comes to these trolls, I gotta be honest, as far as I'm concerned, and as far as most people are concerned, you're just not a music fan. I mean, people like this are not music fans at all, and it just highlights how little else of worthwhile you've got to occupy your time that you should go and be doing something like this. Because look, there's always going to be music that various people don't like. There's music that I'm not really particularly into, but to go and actively find that music, find the premieres, and then hang out there trying to harass people, it just really makes you look pathetic. And moreover, if you feel like you're representing another band perhaps, then all it does is just make you an embarrassment to that community, because I'm pretty sure that the bands who you like wouldn't be particularly impressed to see you in another band's premiere acting like a dick. And then you throw that on top of the fact that Hanabie are a band who they've had like threats, they've had to increase the security at their gigs. This is something that we covered on an Ears to the East video. I mean, it's just to me absolutely baffling, because when I listen to Hanabie, I think this is the sort of band where, love them or hate them, they should really be kind of like a great unifier. So say what you will, but personally, I'm going to be supporting Hanabie's success even when they're dropping songs a little bit too heavy for me. Even when I'm not big into, say, the growling vocals in certain songs and certain people are saying, wait, Howard, how can you like Hanabie if you don't like the growling vocals? I'm going to be supporting them because as far as I'm concerned, if you can listen to Hanabie and not just sort of be like, this is really creative. This is what drives music forwards. This is something that we should all be behind. If you can not get that, then frankly, I don't know why you're into Japanese music. So there you go. I think that, yeah, listen to Hanabie, enjoy them, whether it be your thing or not, just get behind the sheer force of creativity involved here. And let's all enjoy music together. There you go. Those are my thoughts. As always, get in the comments, tell me what you think. Until I hopefully see you very soon in Japan for the next one of these, enjoy music. And for now, ciao, ciao.